In this video, I discuss the fuel supply system for a automobiles. For a automobile means it is either for a petrol engines or either for a diesel engines. So first we understand the various component of a fuel supply system for automobiles, then we understand it workings. So first component is the fuel tank in which the fuel is filled. Then from the fuel tank, fuel is supplied to the fuel filters. Then after this, fuel is supplied to the fuel pump, and from the fuel pump, the fuel is supplied to the carburetors. And we already know that in a carburetors, the two things are mixed. One is the air and second one is the petrols. This diagram you see, it is for the SI engines. Okay, when we use the carburetors, it is for a SI engine, means spark ignition engine, means a petrol engines. So here the air filter is provided. In air filter, air is input. So air filter is generally remove the dust particles from the air, and this air is further supplied to these carburetors. And amount of the air is controlled by using the choke valves. So in a carburetors, we supply the two things. One is the petrol and the second one is the air. And this mixture of the air and petrol is supplied to the engine. Okay, and amount of the mixture means amount of the charge is controlled by using the throttle valve. So when we talk about our bike, okay, our accelerator is controlled this throttle valve. Okay, and this choke valve is generally provided when the our bike is not start. What we doing? We off the choke valve. When we off the choke valve, that is a rich mixture is supplied, means more petrol is supplied compared to the air, and the less air is supplied, the engine is started easily. In a engine, here it is a spark plug and this is the exhaust valve. So these are the basic components of the fuel supply system, that is the fuel tank, fuel filter, fuel pump and the carburetors and air filters. Now next we understand the working in details. Before that, I request to like the video, and if you don't subscribe the channels, then subscribe for watching the board video related to mechanical engineering. And also visit the playlist for watching the various subjects of mechanical engineering. And the IC engine various video link is already available in the descriptions or a top right screen of your mobile. Here you see the I symbol, from that you go to the various playlist. So again, I use this figure for better understanding. In an automobile, generally fuel tank is placed far from the engine for safety and convenient purpose. Means far away means it is placed at the certain distance from the engine. So here you see, this is the engine and this is the fuel tank. They have a certain distance to avoid the fire. Generally fuel tank placed at the lower level compared to the carburetor as shown in this figure. So here you see, this is the carburetors and this is the fuel tank. Mean fuel tank is at the lower level compared to the carburetors. Therefore fuel pump is required to lift the petrol from this fuel tank to the carburetors. So fuel tank is in the lower level, carburetor is in upper level, that's why we need the pump. And pump is supplied the fuel, means petrol, from this fuel tank to the carburetors. In a motorcycle, means in our two wheeler or in our bike, the fuel tank is placed above the carburetors. Okay, so the fuel pump is not required. So in our bike, there no fuel pump is used because the tank is in a upper level and carburetor is below the tank. In a CI engine means compression ignition engine or a diesel engine, fuel pump is essential. Means in a SI engine, means petrol engine, the fuel pump is not compulsory. It is depending on the location of the fuel tank. Okay. But in CI engine, the fuel pump is compulsory required. Okay. Why? Because the fuel pump is used to injecting the fuel with very high pressure. Okay. Means suppose this is a CI engine, then what they happen? The spark plug is not provided because the power stroke is produced due to the, or a fire is due to the higher pressure and temperature of the compressed air. Okay. So instead of spark plug, fuel injector is provided, and this fuel injector is sprayed a diesel inside the engine. That's why the fuel pump is compulsory used in a CI engines. While in SI engine, fuel pump is required only to lift the fuel from this fuel tank to the carburetors, or either fuel pump even not is used in a case of the motorcycle because the fuel tank is in upper level and carburetor is in the below the fuel tank. A single pump which diaphragm can be used for this purpose. So pump, that is a various type of the pump is available. So generally diaphragm type of the pump is used. Diaphragm move up and down. It creates the necessary suction to suck the petrol from the fuel tank. And diaphragm may be operated mechanically, means it is a mechanical pump, or electrically in case of the electrical pumps. Fuel from the fuel pump enter to the carburetor, means when we fuel is first supplied to fuel tank to fuel pump, then after fuel is supplied to the carburetors. Okay, and air from the atmosphere passes through this air cleaner or air filters and then enters to the carburetors via choke valve. Choke valve is regulate the amount of the air supply to the carburetor. Choke valve will reduce the flow of the air during the starting to make the rich mixer so that engine will easily start. In carburetor, fuel and air mix with each others, and this mixing of the fuel and air is known as a charger, okay, in a proper proportions and then supplied to the engine. Means this charge is supplied to the engine, in between that throttle valve is provided. And how the throttle valve is controlled? By using the accelerator in a two wheel as well as in a four wheelers. So when we press the accelerators, at that time throttle valve is open and the more air fuel mixer is supplied, means more charger is supplied to the engines. Similarly, in a bike, we rotate the accelerators and this throttle valve is open and more amount of the fuel and air is supplied to this engine. The quantity of mixture supplied to the engine is controlled by throttle valve according to this requirement of power. Therefore, SI engines are known as the quantity governing engine. Okay, because it's only control the quantity, because quality is already maintained in the carburetor. So we don't change the quality of the charge. Okay, we only change the quantity, means amount of the charge supply is controlled by using this throttle valve. That's why it is known as the throttle governing. And video of the governing is already available. So you can watch the various video related to governing from this I symbol as well as in the description. The link is provided, or you also visit the playlist. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels, and don't forget to share with your friend.